serves it. It's Speedway. Young and old, they come in their thousands to see the champions, Speed, and to enjoy the thrill of that great pastime, Speedway racing. There they come. Of course, others prefer to participate more actively in another favourite sport, for instance, a snappy game of bowls. And, of course, the never-ending debate on the results. Or again, the royal and ancient game, golf. A long straight drive, a pitch to the green, and down in one for that birdie three. Or if you're feeling particularly energetic, a Sunday afternoon vigorously working in the garden might be more to your taste. This is a comfortable chair, and after all, the book does tell you how to do it. Again, the evenings offer opportunity, and what better can be suggested than an hour at the local? A chat with the boys, dominoes, that's right, old man, don't rush it, and of course the old standby darts. That first double seems to be elusive. Ah, he's got it, and now the game is well underway. After one for the road, they leave in the best of spirits, all good pals together. But if they're seeing things this way, they certainly won't appreciate these enjoyments of the teenagers having a ball game. Swimming, just fooling away a pleasant afternoon at the baths. Lots of fun to watch, lots of fun to do. There could be some Olympic material here. Oh, look, the meanies, they're going to throw her in. And throw her in they do, but she doesn't seem to mind. Dancing always has an attraction for the young people. They may not be the most expert, but they'll improve and enjoy themselves while doing it. Table tennis, ping pong, doesn't matter what you call it, Wimbledon never had anything like this. And those great builders of character, the Boy Scouts, from reveille and inspection through a busy day to tattoo. They're training for the time in the future when they will have to take over more serious responsibilities of life. While members of their sister organization, the Girl Guides, are busy and happy also. In this instance, taking care of the little ones while the parents are looking about the grounds at their leisure. And a good job they're making of it. Pigeons at Trafalgar Square, what memories that brings back to all of us. And we mustn't forget to bring along our share of the crumbs for them. Tame, aren't they? These little ones will remember this day for a long time to come. And of course, from Trafalgar Square, the natural thing to do is to walk down Whitehall to Horse Guards Parade. The horses are as friendly as ever. And the guardsman in his traditional dress is a very imposing figure. But now we must leave. That's it. Look right, look left, look right again. And if the road is clear, quick march. You'll always get across safely if you live up to that. And now back again in our own playground. The slides are great fun. Feet first, head first, upside down, it doesn't matter. And again, in our playground, as elsewhere, what we lose on the roundabouts, we gain on the swings. Ah, now this requires skill, team play, and a perfectly adjusted sense of balance. The railwaymen of the future, drivers, guards, signalmen, all intent on the smooth and efficient operation of this miniature railway and dreaming of the day when they'll be handling the big ones. Come on, admit it, from 7 to 70, we all enjoy watching the trains. Yes, these can be yours, and are yours, these pleasures of everyday life. Only the other evening, world champion Tommy Price gave his autograph to Bill Jones and made him the envy of all the other fans who collect around the pits and try in every way to absorb the atmosphere of this most fascinating sport, so that they may feel more strongly that they too, with the riders, are participants, not merely spectators. Bill and his girlfriend are real Lion fans, and every Thursday evening you could find them at the stadium cheering their favorites and really enjoying life. Friday evening always found Harry Smith and his wife attending the old-time dances at the town hall. The dimmed lights and gay music and the company of old friends made for an atmosphere of pleasure and enjoyment. It was the highlight of their week. Both were excellent dancers and drew many admiring comments as they danced to the strains of the old-time waltzes. Rationing is a problem, but to Mrs. Brown, the effort is all very much worthwhile. Her greatest interest in life is her home, preparing the meals from restricted rations and taking care of her family. With a grown-up daughter and son, as well as a spoilt and pampered husband, well, that takes a lot of doing these days, but she accomplishes it. And with justifiable pride, she sees the look of expectation on their faces turn to expressions of complete contentment as the plates empty. And her reward is her own sense of accomplishment, which makes her feel that everything is worthwhile and all's well with the world. Once a week after the work is finished for the day, the family relax in the living room to enjoy a game of bridge with the neighbors. John and Mary never go out that evening. There's too much fun at home, watching and listening to the age-old battle of friendly enemies at the card table. I did not revoke. I followed your lead every trick. What do you think of that? She always accuses me of not following suit. Clubs are trumps. Mr. Brown is going to give them all a surprise in his own quiet way. In those days, but today there is no warning. Bill Jones doesn't go to the speedway now. Last Thursday, he and his girlfriend left work together at knocking off time, full of beans at the prospect of another happy evening of Up the Lions. Bill thinks these road safety slogans don't refer to him. They do, Bill, to everyone. Bill left his girlfriend at the corner with his usual admonition, don't be late, as though she would, and walks away happily up the street. Look out, you idiot! Don't open that door! The next evening, Friday, Harry Smith, hurrying home from work, happy in the thought of another old-time dance, without a care in the world, went to cross the road in front of his bus. He didn't make it. A witness, remembering what she'd been taught, rushed immediately to the telephone to dial 999. And when the operator had taken over, she knew the ambulance and police would be on the way at once. There we are, the radio call comes through. And in a matter of seconds, they're on the scene of the accident, quickly followed by the ambulance. Jobs of this sort are part of a police officer's duty, but they shouldn't be necessary. Sir Alcott Tripp, Assistant Commissioner of Police at Scotland Yard, states that 90% of the total casualties are caused by unexpected encounters such as this accident. Over 50,000 people are killed or injured on the roads each year in London. 1,000 each week. And it would require so little more care on the part of all of us to prevent these painful and unnecessary accidents. Ambulance services are perfectly organized and greatly alleviate the pain and suffering, but they cannot undo the hurt and harm that has been caused by one moment's carelessness. To quote again, the Archbishop of York says, "The casualty figures and the general attitude towards them are a scandal to our nation and civilization. We are so much accustomed to such losses," he said, "that we are beginning to take them for granted." Some advice for the future. Please think what you are doing when using any highway. This simple advice applies to all, from the young pedestrian to the lorry driver. Motorists, please be on your guard against the careless, irresponsible, or absent-minded road user who may be a danger. Pedestrians, when you go shopping or playing, you probably do not consider you yourself are part of the traffic of the town. But you are a traffic unit, you know, and a very important one. Never knowingly take a risk, and especially when in a hurry. Remember, it takes longer to arrive via the hospital. To all classes of road users, an appeal is made to show extra consideration to the young and aged. This is tough on the police. They don't like jobs like this. It's been tougher on Harry Smith. He didn't want it this way. But it's toughest of all on Mrs. Smith, who has been so happily awaiting Harry's return. Mrs. Brown is on her usual round of morning shopping, worried about whether the points will last out the period or not. Thank goodness some articles are not rationed. I'll concentrate on them today. Ah, well, a quiet evening at home tonight, no one coming in. A good novel will be entertaining and soothing. Plenty to choose from. I'll just cut across the road behind this van to the bus stop. Let's see, those points. 2, 4, 7. I'll just make it. No, it wasn't fatal, but how it did disrupt the smooth running of the household. Mary has the jitters from the rush and bother of preparing the meal. Dad doesn't like burnt offerings and doesn't hesitate to say so. But Mother is appalled at the realization that she is one of the many casualties reported in the local paper this week. John isn't much help in preparing the meal, so he must do his part in clearing up. Look out! Oh, those dishes, and they're so hard to replace. Missed one, did I? I'll soon fix that. These can be yours. They are yours. But these better things of life can be sacrificed and lost by just a moment's thoughtlessness. Think. Will next year find you lying like this? Or like this? Or like this? Or like this?